Hi everybody, on our fifth day of the 104th FIDI seminar. This is the last official day with Mr. Mahdi Abdulrahim, so we need everybody to be concentrating. Tomorrow we will only have a small lecture about one of the end games. Most probably I'll be giving that as a lecture assistant to Mr. Mahdi. And then on Friday we will have a master giving the final lecture also of a few end games. I think Mr. Mahdi gave you a few cases regarding the flag fall. When the flag falls for some positions or some end games, he mentioned when to be considered as a win and when to be considered as a draw. So I think these two lectures, tomorrow and the day after tomorrow, will help the arbiters, plus, of course, helping you as players. But officially, tonight will be, or today or tonight will be, the last hours with officially with Mr. Mahdi. If anyone has any questions from yesterday or any day of the previous 4 days, so we are welcome to receive the questions. And I think now we can give Mr. Mahdi the opportunity to start his lecture. So best wishes for everybody.
Thank you very much, Mr. Rubai. Thank you for everybody attending today. As he said, Mr. Rubai, today is last day, and we have many material for today to cover. I'm trying my best to give you, because we have a title of arbiters, we have rating calculation, and we have pairing system. So three subjects and heavy subjects. So I don't know if can cover today or not, or I, in short, in brief, I give you the important points for each, and I send you the all documents, you can study from the documents. And before we start regarding the exam will consist of more than 30 questions or 40 questions. And the exam is divided according to the subjects. So all questions are based on the standard games. When we say we call the standard game, the standard games are considered 40 moves in 90 minutes with an additional 30 minutes and with 30 second increment from move one. Unless indicate otherwise, the special rule for the rapid and blitz apply unless the information given the question indicated otherwise. So any illegal move in the question mean first illegal move. So any illegal move in the question, this means this first illegal move. Then, the question will be, the marks will be divided on the subjects. Question on the laws of chess will be 55 mark, which 55%. A question on the tournament will be 6 marks. Question on the tie breaks will be 6 mark. Question on the Swiss pairing will be 10 marks. And question on the title and rating, regulation will be 15 marks. And question on the arbiters will be 3 marks, be careful. Question on the anti-cheating will be 5 marks. So total 100 marks, and the pass exam pass 80%. Besides the question will be, in bracket will be marks. We're showing which question, how many marks, 2 or 1 or 3 marks. So you have go for the highest mark and start with the highest mark, then go for the lowest mark. And the exam will cover all which we took, and will be on Saturday, same time of this, like today time, will be from 7 p.m. Cairo time until 10 p.m. Cairo time, 3 hours exam. You have to come half an hour before, attend to the Zoom, and the Zoom must be open. Then when you attend, I give you the exam link. Then you can go to the exam link and try to solve. And I will be with you online with the technical. Mr. Kekishan is the technical of the exam. He will be with us. And if not, I won't be there in the system. I will check who's sitting for exam or not. And once you finish all exam, submit. Don't go backward. If you go backward, they will take you out of the exam. You have to re-enter, so you lose the time, and you have to enter again the answers. So be careful. Don't go out of the Zoom from the exam. You have to continue until all last answer. When you finish last question, all questions, then submit. Once you submit, call me I will be with you in the Zoom that, okay, already I submit. I will check the system. If I receive the answer, okay, no, you can leave the Zoom. Then again, I repeat, don't go back, so backward by arrow. Don't go out from the exam. If you go out, maybe you lost the opportunity for maximum two times. That's the second time you will be failed from exam. So don't go out, always be there. So move, time counter will be go down. Once you enter to the link, start from 3 hours, will come 2 hours, 59 minutes, 59 seconds, and so on. Counter down will be for your time. So be careful. Don't miss any question and don't go out for exam. This is about the exam. And now-
Mr. Mahdi?
Yes.
Sorry, regarding the time of the exam, maybe we need to discuss it maybe again with everyone because of the difference of timing. We then fix a suitable time for everybody.
We cannot be change that time. We'll be fixed time for everybody. Same condition. They have to enter the. They have to enter the, to the Zoom, and I will control from the Zoom 3 hours. Then they can I give them a link, one link, all for everybody. Same link. They set same time for exam. No different time. Must be all in same time.
Yeah, I mean the beginning time, the starting time of the exam. Maybe we need to check with everybody. Just the starting time only.
No problem. Check with them. But now. From 7 p.m. Cairo time. If they want to 6 p.m., 5 p.m., okay, just tell me and confirm with everybody to be suitable for everybody.
Okay. And is there any possibility also to discuss whether it could be on Sunday also or no?
I don't know. Sunday maybe not suitable for others.
No, I'm just asking just like an option. So when we discuss all together, in the WhatsApp group, then we know that there are two options, for example.
For me, no problem. Sunday, okay. Saturday, for me, no problem. But make confirmation with everybody.
Thank you. Okay. Then we will discuss that in the WhatsApp group. Okay. You may continue, Mr. Mahdi. Okay.
Thank you very much. Can you give me share, please?
Just a second. Share is open now.
Thank you very much. Okay, let's now start our session. Okay. You can watch my data show?
Yes, we should.
Okay, thank you very much. So we spoke about the title of the players and we have the title of the arbiters. So arbiters title, we have three different titles. We have, first of all, we have national arbiter. To be FIDE arbiter, you have to be national arbiter. To be national arbiter, you have to sent to the FIDE or National Federation has to send to the FIDE list of the arbiters, national arbiter, and ask to give them national license, national arbiter license. Then once the National Federation transfer money, which is 20 euros for each national arbiter, then the FIDE commission, arbiters FIDE commission, they approve and publish in the website, FIDE website. Once they publish, then this will be the arbiter became national arbiter licensed. So in this case, once he got licensed, he can acting as an arbiter in any event. So the following regulation can only be altered by the General Assembly. So and this is must be approved by arbiters commission. Change to the regulation shall only be made every 4 years. So same like arbiters, laws of chess every 4 years. Even for the arbiter's regulation for title and so on must be every 4 years. Concerning from 2004, start this regulation, then affected from 1st July. So every 4 years from 1st July, it affect for change, if there's any change. The title for award, international arbiter and FIDA arbiter. So now we have international arbiter and FIDA arbiter. Long time was only international arbiter, no FIDA arbiter. And was the conditions was very easy, just act with the unrated event for 4 events is enough. No need exam, nothing. But now then the career is something like FIDA arbiter. Of FIDA arbiter, you have to sit to the seminar like this seminar and pass the exam, then you will go to first norm. After you got the first norm, then you can act as an arbiter in 3 rated tournament. The title are valid for life for the date awarding of register. So once you got FIDA arbiter title or international arbiter title, this will be for a life. The judging unit is the FIDA arbiters commission. They are responsible for these all titles. Then we have the presidential board or executive board of FIDA Council. They have to confirm the title after recommendation of the arbiters commission. So we have also national federation may register their arbiters of a national levels with the FIDA after approved by the FIDA arbiters commission. So we see how many national arbiter we have, for example, 10, 20, 15, then make one list. We send to the FIDA and request to issue the to award them national arbiter to become licensed. Once you become licensed, so you can active. If you are not licensed, cannot acting as a arbiter in any event. For example, if you act became arbiter in one rated event and you didn't license, so in this case, this event will not rate it because arbiter was not licensed. Then the general regulation we have to give norm, we have from the Swiss system and from round robin or other level. Then the norm got from the world championship, from the continental, from national championship type, for individual and team competition. And the certificate number of norm certificate to be issued. So after you acting the arbiter, in the any event, rated event, then the chief arbiter, the issue certificate for you. And this certificate must be cross-table with the ITR, IT3, which is a tournament report, then signed and stamped by organizer. Then they have norm that can be used in the application from this event. So, he has to submit to you norms and certificate or and cross table with the event. Then we have so many times of events level to get our norm. So all kind of world championship, they give norm. So no limit for certificate and no limit for the norm. So they give all kind of continental championship. If there's youth, adult, under category, any type of continental, even there are no limitation, any kind, no limit for certificates and no limit for the norm. Swiss international, any kind, they give for each 50 players, give one norm. For each 50 players, one norm, but by next year, I think there will be change. I think became every 25 players give one norm. At the moment, the current every 50 players in Swiss tournament, they give one norm. If we have 100 players, so we got 4 norms. So no limit, any type of the Swiss can be. Round robin international, any kind of round robin international, team round robin or individual double round robin, the maximum give 2 norm and no limit. So give 2 norm. So if for the candidate must not use more than 2 norm for achievement of a title. Only maximum 2 norm from round robin can be the third norm from Swiss system. are opposite. Can be two from Swiss, one from Round Robin. Not all from Round Robin. Swiss national championship individual team adult must be adult. From the for national championship individual, men or more woman for adult, the only one pair 50 players, so maximum 2 nor. So you can get 2 nor from national championship, but must be for adult, not for the young players and youth. Round robin national championship individual or team for adult, maximum they give 2. So you give 2 certificate maximum and 2 norm. So not be all your norm from national, not accept. Maximum only 2 norms accept from national championship. Rapid chess for world and continental and any kind of no limitation, maximum 1. So you can get 1 norm from the rapid chess or blitz, only 1 norm, such as world championship or continental championship, only 1. If you, for example, became act as arbiter in the world championship blitz or rabbit, you have to select 1 of them, or blitz or rabbit, 1 of them, only 1 norm is considered. Then we have arbiter in the highest division of the national team championship, for example, national cup, UAE National Cup or President Cup. So this is a high level division. They give also the norm. The minimum of the 4 board for the team competition or for clubs competition. So a minimum must be 4 boards per team, minimum. And minimum of 10 teams and 6 teams for double round. Okay, to get norm from the round robin system for the clubs championship, from the clubs must be minimum, we have 10 teams, 10 clubs and 9 rounds, and minimum would be 4 boards, maybe 2 reserve or 1 reserve, but must be 4 main board, 4 tables. And then if we have 6 teams or 6 clubs, we can go for double round. In this case, accept for double round, which is the 10 games, 10 rounds, maybe this is acceptable. But there is condition. At least 60% of the players are federated. So if the 10 clubs we have and minimum 4 boards, and must be 60% of the participants rated player. Then to get norm, enough for me, at least 5 rounds. If I acting as arbiter in the club championship, so in this case, enough for me 5 rounds. After 5 rounds, if I don't like to continue, no problem. So 5 rounds is enough for team championship. 2 different format must be tournament include as a norm for the application for both FIDE arbiter and international arbiter title. 2 different format must be from Swiss and round robin or team tournament. If all norms from Swiss, it's not accept. All norms from round robin, it's not accept. Must be 2 different format. But there is, if the one of Swiss system, 100 players and more, this is considered as a festival. So this time will be different format. So no problem if I have 3 Swiss and one of them is 100 and more. In this case, the all norms are acceptable. So only Swiss system tournament may be accepted in case that at least one of them in the international FIDE rated chess event with at least 100 players and at least 30% FIDE rated. So this is condition. Okay, 100 players, but 1/3 or 30% FIDE rated player. If we have 100 players, so 30 players must be rated players and at least 7 rounds. If the tournament for 4-6 rounds, not get any norm title. At least will be 7 rounds. Then in order for the international FIDE rated chess event to be valid as a norm, for the FIDE arbiter title, it must have participant from at least 2 different federations. So for FIDE arbiter, we need to be at least from 2 different federations. For IA, we need three different federations, because IA, the requirement is a little bit more than FIDA arbiter. So in order for the international FIDA rated chess event to be valid as a norm for IA title, it must have participants from at least three federations. So here are differences, a different from FA and IA. So FA must be at least two federation, and for IA must be three different federation. Then we have players whose designation by FIDA. If he has FIDA flag, he's played by FIDA. Maybe his federation, as yesterday I spoke, federation maybe temporarily stop, not active. Or banded. In this case, okay, we have player, but they play under FIDA flag. They call it FID. So do not count it as the federation. In this case, if we have, for example, in the event, one federation plus FID, so this not considered as two federations, considered as one federation. So in this case, cannot go to norm. Application for the title of IAFA must be at least applicant must be 25 years old. So for national arbiter must be at least 16 years old for national arbiter. For the IA and FA must be minimum 25 years old and so on. Then all the following, the through knowledge of the laws of chess. So arbiter must have knowledge of the laws of chess, the FIDA regulation, chess competition, and Swiss pairing and a Swiss pairing system. So he has to be knowledge how to make Swiss pairing, how to make use the regulation of competition, how to give sanction, how to add minutes or reduce minutes, how to use Article 12.9. This is all must be considered. Absolute objectivity demonstrated at all time during his active as an arbiter. So arbiter must always be in the tournament, not be outside the tournament to speak with the friends or have always go to toilet or go to the restroom, go to the bar, so leave the tournament or not. He must be active. For the chief arbiter, he at the end of the tournament, he writes the report on behalf of the each arbiter acting in this event. Sufficient knowledge of the at least one official FIDA language. So we said we have seven different FIDA language, include Arabic, French, Spanish, Germany, Portuguese, Russian, and so on. So has to be at least one FIDA language knowledgeable. The skill to be operate electronic clocks of different type of different systems. So arbiter must be knowledge how to set up the clock. If I said, okay, we have time control 90 minutes plus 30 second increment. So in this case, you are responsible on the so many games, you have to go and fix and install all time control in the clocks. Then experience as arbiter at least three FIDA rated events. This is for FIDA arbiter to get norm. So you have to be experienced at least in three FIDA rated events. And this can be either national or international. So from national, maximum two norm we can get. And from international, it's unlimited. And the attendance of at least one FIDA arbiter seminar and success passing like this seminar and at least 80%. So examination test set up by the arbiters commission, FIDA rated event valid for the norm. For the norm seminar valid only 4 years. So once you got, once you pass the exam, the seminar, the validation of this norm 4 years. So within 4 years, you have to get your title. If the 4 years expires, then you have to go for another seminar. So set for another seminar. So FIDA rated event valid for the norm is considered by the tournament with minimum 10 players in case of round robin. So for round robin, 10 players is enough to get a norm. For double round, 6 players is enough. And players, in case that it is played with the double round. since six players are enough, with a minimum of 20 players in case that is played with a Swiss system. So in the Swiss system, the minimum must be 20 players. Then the title of the FIDE arbiter for each of the IPCA and ICCD, IPCA shall, this for disabled and handicapped players, shall each be equivalent to the one FIDE norm. So they got one FIDE norm. For a candidate being the match arbiter in the Olympiad, for example, chess Olympiad, and they give one FIDE norm. So cannot be two times. If you've been acting as a match arbiter in two Olympiad, only they give one norm, not more than one more such norm will be considered for the title. Being arbiter in any federated and rapid or blitz events with a minimum of 30 players, okay? The blitz and rapid and Swiss system standard chess minimum is 20 players. For the blitz and rapid, minimum 30 players. So we have different here, 30 for blitz and rapid players, and nine rounds, must be nine rounds, shall be equal to the one FIDE arbiter norm. So no more than one such norm from rapid or blitz tournament will be considered for that title. For example, I act for four event, two from blitz and two from rapid. So only out of four, only one norm. Attendance for the one FIDE arbiter seminar was 30% exam. So we said this is equal for one norm, not more than one such as norm will be considered. If you attend more than three seminar within period of 4 years, this consider as one seminar, only one norm. Note that there is no age restriction on the attending the arbiter seminar. So no, can you enter arbiter seminar? You have 16 years, 17 years, but be careful because norm validation is 4 years. So if you enter your age 16 years, so by 20 years, when you reach 20 years, that this will be expire. If you have four norms, cannot get your title because requirement to get title FA or IA must be 21 years year old. However, a norm generated in this way is valid for only 4 years. So validation for the norm from the seminar, 4 years. While validation norm from the tournament, rated tournament, 6 years. So we have here different from seminar norm, 4 years for the rated tournament, federated tournament, validation of norm is 6 years. So, and there is an age restriction of 21 in being and FIDE arbiter of international arbiter. So age must be 20 years. Okay, for example, the candidate was the age 20 years old and already all norms submit, all norms correct, and exam norm from the exam from seminar was correct. So in this case, once the National Federation submit this norm to the arbiters commission, FIDE arbiters commission, they looked at the all norm. Then we find all norms is okay, but condition, the right condition. Okay, this is approved, they accept, but condition. What is condition? Because of age, the candidate must be 21 years old age to get the title. So the condition will be until he reach 21, then National Federation can request for the title, achievement, and they will give immediately title. So no need to bring another norm or go for the seminar. So only condition of the age. Those younger than 17 maybe still find attendance at the seminar useful if they want to be a national arbiter. So from 17 years, yes, can be, because 17 to 21, 4 years, which is the validation of the norm from seminar. Applicants from the federation which are unable to organize any tournament valid for the title or rating may be awarded the title on passing the examination set by the arbiters commission. So there are some countries, some federation, they are not organizing even during the year. So difficult to organize such as rated tournament for, and there's very specific country, Arbiters Commission, they have a list. Then from the list, they know if any of you with us in this seminar, such as federation, the federation not organizing rated event within two years. In this case, if they attend the seminar, they give title direct. So you got the title direct, not norm. So this is something, exception they made from the Arbiters Commission. So for the title or the rating, may be awarded the title on the passing and examination set by the Arbiter Commission. So direct title you got. Then we have requirement for the title of international arbiter. The requirements, all of the following: through the knowledge of the laws of chess, must be knowledge of laws of chess and FIDE regulation and even Swiss system pairing and FIDE regulation regarding achievement of the title norm and the FIDE rating system. He must be knowledge because he's now become international arbiter. Absolute objectivity demonstrated at all times during his activity. Must be always to be in the tournament venue. Obligatory knowledge of the English. So in IA, they give obligatory to knowledge of the English language. So this is obligatory. But for FIDE or FIDE arbiter, can be any seven languages. But here, minimum at conversation level. So not need to be perfect in English, but in the level, minimum level conversation. So you understand, you can explain to the players what mean illegal move, why I give two sanctions to add 2 minutes or reduce minutes. So you have be little level of conversation to understand, the player understand what you're saying, okay? So in this case, must be low level, no need to be high level, and for chess term in other official FIDE language. Okay, if for example, in the event, you don't understand the player's language, in this case, I have to get assistance from my chief arbiter or assistant from other colleagues who knows the language of this player, then in this case we can translate and we know what's happened. For minimum skills at user level to work on the personal computer. So international arbiter here, more job has than the national arbiter or FIDE arbiter. He must be knowledge how to use pairing system program and use a Word, Excel. So here, because he's a chief arbiter, he has to send reports. If he doesn't know how to work with the Excel sheet, with the Word, so in this case will be problem. So how to use email also, this will be problem. So you have to be knowledge about pairings program and the FIDE, Word, Excel, and so on. So Excel to operate electronic clocks, this is important, especially in if we have tiebreak system, and during the game, if you have one or two tiebreak system, you have to be knowledge how to set up, to install the time control, different time control in the clock. So experience as an arbiter in at least four federated events such as the following. So now the level of the tournament for IA is different from FIDE. For FIDE arbiter, only you need to act as a arbiter in three different rated tournament. But for the IA, it's different. You need high level of event, which they give title to the players. So here is the difference. Then the final of the national individual adult champion, maximum of two. So in the national adult, they give maximum two norms, same as FIDE arbiter. And all official FIDE tournament and matches, they give norm. International tournament where FIDE title norm. So here's the difference. For FIDE arbiter, not consider international tournament will give title norm, which is not necessary to be title norm rated is enough, but for international arbiter, this is requirement, international tournament where FIDE title norm for players are possible. Okay, if there is no title norm, did not give you the norm. International FIDE rated chess event which at least 100 players, so we consider as festival, 100 or more, we say consider as a festival, and this will be different format, so this is acceptable, and they give norm for at least three different federations. So 100 player, at least three different federation, at least 130% of FIDE rated players. This is all condition required for to get norm. And at least 7 rounds, so only one. So if the tournament, system of tournament, it's 7 rounds, okay, this is accept for 100 players, 7 rounds, only one norm accept. So if we act for 2 or 3 different event with 100 and with 7 rounds, only accept one norm from out of 3 of events. So all official world and continental, rabbit and blitz championship for adult and juniors, they got only one, maximum one norm. You have whatever, rabbit or blitz, one of them, only one can use norm for achievement of title. The title of the international arbiter for each of the IBICA and this disabled blind people shall each be equivalent to one IN norm, so give one IN norm. Being a match arbiter in the Olympiad, even they give one norm, no more than one norm from chess Olympiad. All the norm for the IA title must be different from the norm already used for the FIDE arbiter title. For example, I have 6 norms before I got my title, FIDE arbiter title, I have 6 norms. The requirement, 3 norms only to get my title with the exam, with the seminar norm. So I have 6, so I use 3 norms. I still have the remaining 3 other norms. So what shall I do? After I got my title, so I have to go and find another new norm. So this remaining 3 norm cannot use. So once you got your title, you have to go and find another 3 or 4 norm. So in this case, all norm from the IA title must be different from the norm already used for the FIDE arbiter title and must have been achieved after FIDE arbiter title has been awarded, not before, after. So at least 2 of the submitted norms shall be signed by different 2 chief arbiters. So for example, in IO, in FA, both, if I have 3 norms, or I have 4 norms, so 4 norms or 3 norms, at least be from 2 different chief arbiter, and not be all norms signed by Mahdi Abdurrahim, no. Must be 1 from Mahdi and other 2 or 3 from other arbiter, or maybe each norm from different arbiters, no problem. But here must be minimum from 2 different chief arbiter. Okay, if the national arbiter is a chief arbiter in the rated tournament, who will sign for him? The sign for him, organizer or FIDE national official, he will sign for the national arbiter. Because national arbiter, if he is a chief arbiter in the event, cannot sign for himself and cannot sign for FIDE arbiter. Then we have application procedure. Application format, forms for the title listed. We have, according to the annex, the tournament report, which is the IT3, and we have the cross table, we have submit, and we have the norm, which is IA1 or FA1. If we go for the international arbiter, so we have to use IT3 as a tournament report, and IA1, which is the norm for international arbiter, or FA for the FIDE arbiter, one for each norm, arbiter title. So in this case, for FIDE arbiter, we requirement if 3 things, IT3 3 times for 3 different events, and IA1 3 times for 3 different events, plus IA2. So IA2 is application form. An application form This is we use for fill all three norm to in one application with all dates of the event, place of event, time system, time control, and type of event, Swiss or round robin or team or other. So we have to use the three type of this application. Then for the federated title, the norm must include tournament according to Article 3.5 with at least 7 rounds. So for requiring for the FIDE arbiter, norm at least 7 rounds. If we have 3 norm, 1 9 rounds, 1 8 round, 1 7 round, it's acceptable. No problem. Only one norm must be from 7 rounds. Cannot be 2 from 7 rounds. And we have must be 1 from 5 rounds, which is considered as a team competition. Of if the from round robin system for by 6 players double round, in this case accept also as a norm. For the international arbiter title, the norm must include tournament with at least 9 rounds. So the difference here, we have in the FA title, at least we have 7 rounds. But for the IA title, at least we need 9 rounds, but only one tournament with 7 rounds or 8 rounds is accepted. So 1 out of 4 norms accept if there's 7 or 8 we cannot be 2 7 rounds or 2 8 rounds or 1 7 round or 1 8 round, cannot only one seven or 8 with 3 with the 9 rounds. In case of a norm from team tournament, the number of round where the applicants was in the arbiter must be at least 5. So for team competition, club championship, team championships, for this at least we need 10 teams or 10 clubs and with the 4 boards, and at least 5 rounds is enough. Acting as the arbiter in 5 rounds, it's enough. And it must be indicated in the FA1 and IA1, the application form. All the certificate have to be signed by the chief arbiter and the federation responsible for the tournament. So my norm must be signed by chief arbiter and confirmed by the national federation, stamped and signed by authority, an official of national federation. In case where the applicant is the chief arbiter of the event, then the organizer or federation official may sign the certificate. So if you have national arbiter, so in this case, you cannot give yourself a norm. So here we have chief arbiter, if the national arbiter in the event, the organizer or the federation official may sign the certificate. The chief arbiter is arbiter of national level. So in this case, he cannot sign any certificate for international arbiter title. All norms included in the application must have been achieved in the event with a starting date that fall within a 6-year period. So validation of the norm from the event, from the tournament, 6 years. This is the validation, 6 years. And we said, from the exam, from the seminar, 4 years. So applicants application must be submitted not later than the second FIDE Congress after the date of the at least event listed. So norm from seminars are valid for 4 years. Application must be submitted to the FIDE secretary by the federation of the applicants. Okay. If in case that this federation refused to submit this application to FIDE, so arbiter himself can send like a protest, send to the FIDE arbiters commission, and they will investigate and they will see why federation not sending. Then at the end, arbiter himself can send the documents, application norms, and certificate and transfer fees for the title. So the federation National Federation is responsible for the fees. If the applicant's federation refuse to apply, the applicant can bring his case to the arbiters commission, who will investigate it. If it is found that there is no sufficient reason for the refusal, so the applicant can appeal to the FIDA and apply and pay by himself for the title. And there is a 60 days. We have 60 days deadline in order for the application to be considered properly. So in this case, we have to publish in the FIDA website. In the FIDA website, okay. Before meeting of the Congress or Presidential Board or FIDA Council, 60 days before must be your norm ready. Okay, if the norm was less than 60 days, in this case, you have to pay 50% charge, surcharge 50%. If you pay for application, $50, so you have to add another €50. This will surcharge will be 50%. For application to be considered in the shorter time scale than this, those arriving during the presidential board, during the executive board or general assembly or FIDA council meeting, you have to pay 100% supplement. This means you have to pay €100 plus €50. So €150. So exception, the surcharge may be valid if the last norm was achieved so late. So sometimes what happened? Sometimes happened, okay, I am already act as the chief arbiter or deputy chief arbiter in the four different events, but this event already in this month is still not finished. So to confirm your norm must be wait for next month, beginning of each month, first of each month, they confirm the rating, they confirm the tournament, confirm the norm, will be officially norm confirmed after rated tournament is confirmed. So in this case, if we have in same month still not ended, so this means my norm is not confirmed yet. To be confirmed, I have to wait for next month, but the Arbiters Commission meeting they have this month. What shall I do? I submit, but here they make condition. They put wrote condition. Once you reach the next month, there the condition will be open. They will give you the norm. So all applicants application together with the full details must be posted on FIDA website, minimum 60 days. Period, and this in order for any objection to be loaded. So the main aim of the published 60 days to see if any objection. Maybe you got norm, you participate as an arbiter, acting as arbiter, you travel to one Europe country and you got your norm from this event, but your federation refuses. Wow, how you go there without inform us? For that, maybe refuse, maybe objection will be for the norm. Or maybe you didn't travel, but the chief arbiter is your friend and mentioned your name, one of arbiter who act in this event. So like this kind of cheating. For that, when you publish 2 months before, the objection will be from others. Oh, this guy, this was not arbiter our event. How become arbiter? He's in the other country. So here objections. For that, they need at least 60 days will be published. So then we have, once we got the title, FA title or IA title, so we have to be licensed. How to be licensed? First, we have to pay for our title fees. For the FIDA arbiter, we have to pay €50. For international arbiter, we have to pay €100. After we got our title, we have to send license for title. The license title also is $50 for $100. But depend also category of the arbiter, because arbiter, the qualification make four different category. You have category A level, high level arbiter,
Excuse me, teacher, your audio is off.
Who's unmute me? Okay, someone unmute me. Okay. So in this case,
Mr. Mahdi.
Don't you say to unmute? Someone make unmute. The host make unmute. A title, active arbiter, international arbiter, or FIDE arbiter, and arbiters of national level working in the FIDE-rated tournament shall be charged with a license fee. The license will be valid for life. This is license is for title, is for a life. On the condition, the arbiter remains as an active arbiter and will be in effected from the day after FIDE has received the fees. So you, this title you got on the life, but if you've been inactive within 2 years, so you will be listed in the inactive arbiter. To be active arbiter again, so you have to go and be acting as the arbiter in a rated tournament or title tournaments, then you have to pay your license again. License fee you have to pay again. So the license fee for the arbiter of national level is valid for life, for national, valid for life. Then we have, if an arbiter of national level is awarded the title of FIDE arbiter, the license fee for this title has to be paid to the FIDE. So if your national federation paid, it's okay. If they refuse to pay, you can pay yourself. If an arbiter upgrade his category, for example, from D category to C category, or from C to D, C to B, or from B to A, in this case, we have to pay charge different between the title and different from between the categories. There is charge, this table with the charge will show how you can pay for this charge. If the arbiter upgrade his category only, the difference between the category fees has to be paid to the FIDE. And if the FIDE arbiter achieve the title of international arbiter, the fee for the new title has to be paid to the FIDE. Same thing if the National Federation refused, so I can contact the Arbiters Commission after explanation, then they accept to send by yourself. Then the title, we have a qualification of the arbiter. We have arbiter in category A, category B, category C, category D. So for each category, there is fees. If you reach category A, which is the highest category here, and category A only international arbiter. And this international arbiter can be chief arbiter in the world championship, in the chess Olympiad, in the for world, any official FIDE World Championship, he can be only international arbiter in category A. For that, he has to pay for the license €300. For category B arbiters, only IAs, he can be deputy chief arbiter in any World Championship and Olympiad and so on, and he has to pay €200 license. For C category arbiter, can be international arbiter. If international arbiter has to pay €160, if FIDE arbiter has to pay €120. The last category, which everybody for the beginning enter to this category, which is category D, arbiters, IA, 100%, €100 for the fees, license fee, and for the FIDE arbiter, it was 50, now increased 80, so they increased 30 more. So now became 80 for FIDE arbiters, FIDE €80. For arbiters of national level, only 20. For national level, only 20. Then failure to the pay to the license fee will load to the exclusion from the FIDE arbiters list. If you didn't pay, okay, you have title, for example, you got achieve your title, FIDE arbiter or international arbiter, but you didn't pay the fees. In this case, this consider you as a national arbiter or FIDE arbiter, not international arbiter. So this will be excluded from list of the national arbiter, or excluded from list of FIDE arbiter because you didn't pay your fees. The arbiter license will come into the affected from first of this is affected from first January 2013, and then from 2013 all arbiter of FIDE rated tournaments shall be licensed. So license for FIDE arbiter start from 2013. Before was without license. An arbiter who has become inactive, so is considered not to be licensed anymore. So in order to be active again, the arbiter has to pay for the new license. So if you became inactive, so after join and be active as the arbiter in any event, then you have to pay first for your license again. You have to pay. If you are FIDE arbiter, you have to pay for license 80 euros, and for the if you're international, you have to pay 100 euros. Then we have the tournament shall not be rated and any arbiter nor shall not be accepted. So if you not licensed arbiter and you act as arbiter in any event, and this event must not rated and any norm cannot acceptable. Any arbiter got norm from this event not acceptable, because this event cannot be rated because one or more of arbiter unlicensed. So the license fees will be charged together with the application fees for all awarding arbiter title. For example, once I got a title of FIDE arbiter or international arbiter, I can pay together one time. I can pay, for example, 50 euro for the title and 50 euro for the license, or 80 euros for my license FA together one time. So this is all about the FIDE arbiter titles. And if you have any question before we go to the other subject, thank you very much.
I have a question, sir.
I have a question, Mr. Mahdi.
Yes, tell me.
Hello?
Yes.
For the FIDE arbiter norm and gets 80% or over 80%, then when should he pay the 20 euros for license? Is it when he is issued the FIDE arbiter norm, or after being an FA, after giving the title of FA?
No. This is for if you got FIDE, if you got norm from the seminar, you mean there is no for seminar 20 euros. This has to be organizer pay, such as this seminar must be covered by the organizer seminar 20 euros. If the from beginning the organizer, they charge you 20 euros for the seminar, because some seminars, the organizer announced 20 euros for the FIDE exam and 50 euros for the seminar, both together 70 euros for the to attend this seminar. So your norm is covered by organizers. Our organizer must be submit to the FIDE all norms who succeed the seminar norm. He has to submit and send to FIDE and announce and said, okay, this list of arbiters, they pass the exam, and we in charge, we will pay for all of them, each one 20 euros. But if not mentioned or announced at the beginning for the for you participants, so in this case, you or federation must be sent to the FIDE secretary of then or FIDE Arbiters Commission, okay, we want to pay for the our applicant who joined the seminar in Egypt and passed the exam, and show them the exam dates with the lecturer. So I don't know how with the Ubay, maybe he will cover.
Okay, I'm asking Ubay. I'm asking about the title itself. I mean, but if we pay the 20 euros for each one after after being successful. So if they get another norms for PD arbiters and become PD arbiters, do they?
There is no payment for the norm.
They have to pay again, or only this time for the first time?
No. This is only this 20 euros to attend the exam only. This is not for the norm. This is 20 euros to attend the exam. When you pay 20 euros, this will be confirmed that you enter the exam. If you pass or not pass, they are not care. Just to attend the exam, you have to pay 20 euros. And this 20 euros, who charge you, organizer, or you will sell this up? Because the FIDE commission, we contact with the organizer, with the OBAI. They said, the OBAI, you have 20 people attend the exam, 20 times 20, so 400 euros you have to pay. So now, OBAI, it will be charged to you, or I don't know what system work. So it's up to organizer. This is for exam, not for the norm. Nothing pay for the norm. We pay only for title. This is norm, not title. Is it clear? If you got the title, yes, you pay for title, but this is not title, this is norm.
I have a question.
Yes, please.
At first, thank you for the meeting. It's really interesting. Well, my question is, if I live in a country where there is no international tournaments, like the IDDs tournaments, so can I take an international exam to be an international arbiter? I think that I read this in the handbook, but I want to know, because that is the case of some countries here in South America. I live in Peru. So I live in the Andes. It's like 3,400 meters is really high, and we don't have like a lot of tournaments. So we have to travel abroad to be arbiters in international tournaments. So that is the question. If we can take an international exam, like I know that we are going to take this exam to be the FIDE arbiter. If we are success, we have the norm. But after this, can we take another international exam to be FIDE to be international arbiters?
At the moment, not such a case there, but it is proposal. To get international arbiter title, you have to sit for another seminar and pass the seminar. But till now, not confirmed yet, but this is the proposal. But this not mean if you sit the exam and pass the exam, you got the title. No, you have to act as the arbiter for title rated for four different tournaments.
I know that.
But if your country, some countries, as I spoke from beginning, I said, if some countries not organize such as events, maybe poor country or maybe don't have the such as foreign people living in the same country to participate in this title tournament. In this case, they are okay. They are not give the direct title for IA. They give direct title for the FA only, for FA, for IA. Nothing in the regulation at the moment. In the future, maybe, but now, no, nothing.
Okay. Well, thank you. Great.
But to solve this problem, I know this has happened always with our neighbor countries and Arab countries. Some country like Iraq, like Yemen, these people always have problem, war, and other. They are not organizing such as events. Nothing more than four, five years they are not organizing international event. For once they enter the seminar, they get title FA direct. They give them title FA direct FA title. But for IA, no. For IA, they have to travel to another neighbor country and to attend the event and get norm from this country. This is the only way, this is the only solution.
Okay, great. Thank you.
Thank you.
I have got a question.
Please.
Yes, in the same way to the previous arbiter, How about the hybrid tournament? Is there anything about the possibility to get a norm there?
Okay, for hybrid tournament, there's condition for hybrid tournament, not any hybrid tournament they give title. For example, for continental championship, now we running today, tomorrow, last round of Asian Clubs Championship, Asian Cup Club Championship. Till now, till today, eighth round, FIDE not approved, QC not approved to be rated tournament. If the rated tournament give norm, one norm only for arbiter. Because of not rated tournament, not give norm. Online events, hybrid events, they not give norm. Only if the approved by QC. Okay, the QC, they approve it sometime for the national federation. If the national federation organize hybrid chess and high level adults for the men and women, they give one norm, only one norm. So you have to decide which arbiter give one norm. And for the normal, like such as continental championship, any continental championship, for example, Asian continental championship. So now we are in the tomorrow last round of Asian Clubs Cup Championship. We send email to the QC 2 weeks ago. Till now, nothing approved regarding that this event will be rated or not. If rated, they can give one norm only. If not rated, no norm for the arbiter. And for hybrid chess, each 10 players must be one arbiter for each players. Each venue must be 10 players, and 10 players give one norm. So if the so many venues, so many different cities organized, so in each city maybe give one norm from each city. If two arbiter in same venue, not give two norm, only one norm.
Okay.
But need approval before start the tournament.
I have a question.
Okay.
Yeah. Please.
Okay, first, Mrs. Stavrola, first, because she raised her hand first, please. Stavrola from Greece, and then Mr. Gidi from Indonesia.
Hello. I just wanted to clear something. We mentioned previously that for the application for the FIDE arbiter, the application must not be submitted no later than the second FIDE Congress after the date of the latest event. So how often are there FIDE Congresses, just so that we can see when the second was, when the second after the last event was?
Yeah. For the FIDE Congress, okay, no need to be in the FIDE Congress. FIDE Congress every 1 year, but they have quarter years, they have the FIDE presidential board meeting, or now they call FIDE Council. The FIDE Council, every 3 months they sit for a meeting, and every 3 months they look for the titles, any title, arbiters, organizer, players. So every 3 months, so within three, because I read about this regulation, this regulation not updated, because every 4 years will be updated. So I think by next year will be updated the regulation. So now became every 3 months. So 3 months, very short. So you can get the title. But if every 1 year or every 6 months of second meeting, so this will be a long time, 6 months, every 6 months. But every 3 months, it's okay. So if in this, for example, tomorrow, today we have a FIDE meeting, okay, it was condition, or it was my title norm was not required, it was not according to the condition requirement. So shifted to another 3 months. So they will discuss for another next 3 months. So every 3 months they have meeting, FIDE meeting. But arbiters commission every month they have meeting. So they make their recommendation and approve for the title, then they will send report to the FIDE Council. The FIDE Council, once they set for the meeting, so they look for all titles belong to trainers, arbiters, organizer, and so on.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Gidi from Indonesia.
Okay, thanks for the time given to me. I want to ask, can we take the retest if we not pass the test? And then how to take that the retest or re-exam?
Retest, then, you can retest, but retest, this mean you have to go the nearest seminar and attend nearest seminar. And this depends on the organizer. If the organizer charge you only for exam or charge you for all seminar, then you can go and attend the exam.
Okay, thank you. And then the second, can we know or we can find out the test indicator, maybe in this exam, we have 10 questions, and then in that question, we can solve the maybe rating or error and so on, Mister. Can you know, please?
You need explanation how this exam will be.
Yes.
Okay, exam. You know, exam. There are several and different type of exam. There's rating calculation, their title calculation, and they have position. Some position need to take decision. Maybe 10-15 position. Same like which I show you on the PowerPoint 2 days ago. Such same similar to that, and you have to take decision. It's a flat fall if the illegal move first time, second time, or then in this if there is 3 or 4 repetition, you have to say this is draw or not. If draw, why is draw? Because of stalemate or because no material to win. So you have to explain to get more points, more marks. Because if the if I said explanation, maybe this two parts. So need the decision and explanation. 2 mark for decision, 2 mark for explanation. So be careful. And always in bracket, beside each question, there is mark. How many marks for each question? Then you understand you need the details or no need to details right for the answer. And also maybe multiple choice will be maybe 10 multiple choice will be, and something like essay and to write about tie-break system, what mean of, for example, Buchholz system, what mean of Scheveningen system. So you have to explain what does it mean. And so I think we'll cover all materials which we spoke, and even about requirement of applicator FIDA to send for title, what's requirement? Application certificate you have to send to the FIDA from National Federation to FIDA to get our title, FA or IA, you have to know which application, which certificate we have to send for the FIDA and title calculation. If the player come to you after round 8, he ask you for tomorrow, round what's need, 0.5 point or 1 point. So we have table. I show you already that table and how to enter to the table by rating average. And beside the rating average on the left side will be points. So you can check from the table how many points a player score. Then you can answer if he is, yes, he need 0.5 point or 1 point. So this is easy to know. Or if the one player need to get IM norm or GM norm, okay, you have to check he can get or not. So go for the table, same table and average rating and see how many points he scored. So for that, he will score according to GM 6 points or 7 points. He said, yes, now he required he will achieve norm. We could not achieve norm because he has to get 7 points while he got in the tournament 6.5. So you have to write some small explanation for title also. This all the seminar which I spoke, I teach you on this seminar, not go out of the material and subject which I give you.
Okay, thank you, Mr.
Thank you very much.
Mr. Gerald Chibomba from Zambia. Mr. Gerald.
Yes.
Maybe Mr. Gerald is off for network. There is a written question by. There's a written question from Turkey by Mr. Sevzel Aydemir. He is talking about norms. He had three FA norms. Question is written. Starting from 2017, which is around 4 years, maybe, and more norms from 2 years ago. He's asking that the two norms are from international Swiss tournaments, 9 rounds, and one norm from a national championship with 9 rounds. Do I need a team norm?
Okay, now to answer this question, which year you got your license, national license? This is important.
He said the first one is 2017. This is the first
National license. I'm asking about national license, not about a norm. National license, when he got his national license? Because if he got national license 2020, this all norm is not considered, canceled. So depend on the national license. When he became national license, national arbiter, when he got his license from, as a national arbiter. Once you got a national arbiter license, in this period, you can go and act as an arbiter. Before, no. All the norm will not consider, all be canceled. He has to know when became national arbiter.
And also, there is... he became on 2017. Maybe after becoming the national arbiter, he received his first norm. But is it valid after 4 years?
Norm from tournament, 6 years. Norm from tournament, 6 years. Validation, 6 years. So, for example, if you got the first norm in 2017, so calculate, count as 6 years, 17 until 2023. So valid until 2023, is 17.
So yeah, validation. So the norm from the tournament is 6 years and the norm from the seminars is 4 years.
Okay, if four years, you count the, from the date which you set for the exam until now. If already you pass 4 years, you have to sit for another exam. If still before 4 years, so this is valid. The norm is valid for the from the seminar. And the norm from the tournament, once the tournament rated in the FIDE website, for example, it was rated for 1st November 2017. So you have to count from 7th November 2017 until 6 years, which will be 1st November 2023. This is the 6 year, 23. This is the validation of the norm.
Okay, the last part of his question regarding the same thing, that does he need a fourth norm or no, team norm or no? He said he has two norms of Swiss tournament, 9 rounds, one norm from national championship, 9 rounds.
Okay.
And that's it. So does he need
enough?
Yeah. Yeah. So he has one norm from a national championship.
Yeah, for FIDE arbiter, enough. Three norms for FIDE arbiter, three norms, enough with the exam, with a seminar exam. Norm, this total 4 norms, this is enough for FIDE arbiter.
Deniz from Turkey. Deniz, she's asking that in 2019, she had an FA norm from an international Swiss tournament with 9 rounds. But she, what problem could it be? Should my federation contact FIDE or do it by myself directly to FIDE? I think from what she's explaining, she just got a norm of FA. It's from one tournament. So she did not complete the norms, including the exam of or test of this seminar. So that's what I understand. But the important part, she's asking who will contact. Also, no, I can't see PD online. Denise, you may speak if you like, Denise.
Yeah, they can contact FIDE Arbiters Commission.
No, but she had only one norm. She had only one FA norm. She, I don't think she even sat for a seminar exam.
So this meaning norm before exam?
Yes.
So, no, first of all, when they got the national arbiter title. So once you got national arbiter title, you can act as an arbiter in any event. If you got, for example, your norm in one event, but you still not licensed, you are a national arbiter, but not licensed, then pay for license. So this norm is not considered. If you got your national arbiter, then you go for the event and became acting as an arbiter and you got that norm, this norm, and you have two norms. So three norms must be rated from rated event and from two different format. Cannot be all from Swiss, cannot be all from round robin. So could be from Swiss or from round robin together, and can be from national adult championship. So this is format we have, but the format also, if from Swiss, all, for example, all from Swiss, but at least we need one of Swiss will be 100 participants. If we have 100 participants, so all Swiss is okay, no problem. So we can get our title with a seminar exam. But if one Swiss 20 players, one Swiss 50 players, one Swiss 70 players, so no, not accept. So you have to go for other tournament with a round robin or for the club team championship. So different format, you have to go for the different format. And also must sign by different two chief arbiter, not same chief arbiter. This was a mistake for some applicants. Their title was rejected from FIDE commission. Everything it was good, all requirements were good, but because the norm were signed by one arbiter only, all norms by one arbiter. For this reason, it was rejected. As according to the regulation must be two different chief arbiter to sign for the norm. And for the Zambian or for the, I don't know the Zambia or the arbiter who's with us in the seminar, if their country organizing such as event, rated event, if not organizing within 2 or 3 years written, maybe they got title, direct title FIDE arbiter from this seminar. Maybe good direct title from this seminar.
Okay, that's good. For Denise from Turkey, she said regarding her norm, she checked the FIDE website, the arbiter's mission website, did not see her norm. So are the norms?
No, see, Obey.
Yes.
Okay, see, for any applicants cannot contact direct with a FIDE. Must National Federation contact. In case the National Federation refuse to send his application norm, in this case, he has to contact the arbiter commission. But for any reason, cannot now contact by himself to the FIDE arbiter commission, because FIDE, they deal with the national federation. A national federation arbiter or national arbiter belong to the national federation. For that, they have to always go to be a national federation. National federation by rating officer or by the general secretary, they contact with the FIDE office and with the FIDE arbiters commission for anything. So cannot arbiter himself do that, cannot contact direct to the feeder. Maybe in some countries or some federation, national federation, they have a sanction, they give a penalty or sanction or stop the national arbiter who contact direct to the feeder. So he has to be careful. Don't contact feeder directly. You have to go via national federation.
Yeah, so if anyone gets any norms, can they appear on the website, the PD arbiter's website?
Yes, yes, must page? Be there. If you check in profile and you saw your norm is not published, call your federation or your arbiter's commission and your federation and talk about your norm. What happened? Why is not published the norm? So it has to be published because, okay, the arbiters commission, feed arbiters commission, only they publish when they got email from the national federation. For request of the national federation, they publish the norm. If the national federation not send email and request to publish the norm, it will be not published automatic. For that, when they go to check his profile, he find, okay, I have been arbiter in 2-3 event, but I cannot see any norm published. Why? This is because of your federation. You have follow your federation. Check why they didn't publish your norm.
Yeah, so Denise, the norm will appear on your profile, not on arbiters.com. CD.com page.
No,
it's
no,
on
his
your
profile.
Own profile. That's for the norms.
Yeah, yeah. His profile. When she entered,
I think the last. Yeah.
She obey when she entered to her profile. So when go to the FIDA website, enter FIDA ID, and the FIDA ID will show everything in the profile. It will show if she played any event, the rating. She will find any title, IO title, training title, arbiter's title, and show all norm, if you have norm from GM, I am norm, or norm for the arbiter, all will be in the profile, all in the profile. So if she didn't find in the profile, mean national arbiter, they are not sent her application or her norm. So she has go and check with the federation.
Okay, thanks. Mr. Siddiqui, last question, please.
I waited long for my question. First, I would like to know about the status of the licensed arbiter, like national arbiter. How is it announced that the guy is a national arbiter, licensed national arbiter? And is it published in the FIDE website along with the FIDE ID?
Or what?
Some license? The national
cannot hear you.
License.
Muhammad Siddiq, we cannot hear you.
Do you hear me now?
No, yes, before no, because it was poor connection.
Yeah, it's poor. I wanted to know that how the national arbiter is confirmed that he is licensed. Is it announced with the FIDE ID? Like when someone is a national arbiter, it is depicted that he is licensed. When he enters his FIDE ID, like in my case, I see that I'm national arbiter. I see with my ID and licensed.
Okay, go ahead.
And the second part of my question is that I have already convened many tournaments. I have participated as a deputy arbiter and a chief arbiter and just arbiter. So, are they going to be counted as a norm or not? If I have this exam, will I be able to submit those reports for a norm or should I participate in 3 more events to submit those reports as a norm?
Okay, first of all, regarding to check your name, if you're a national arbiter or any title, even if you're a FIDE arbiter or international arbiter, in FIDE website and go to the arbiter commission. The arbiter commission, you will find article or something like a license arbiter. So when you click to the license arbiter, it will show all arbiters searched by your country. You find beside your name, check your name or by ID or by name. Check if you find your name there. This means you got license. What license will be beside your name? National arbiter or FIDE arbiter or international. If you didn't find your name, this means you still you're not licensed, even not national arbiter, national license. But very easy to find. Okay, and I will see if I got. I will give you also. I will send to you, to everybody. I will send to Ubay to forward to you. If the form which I have, if I find from, I will download and send to everybody. And from this form, the PDF file, you check by your country, you check your name. If your name in the list, this means you already national arbiter license. If you're licensed, your name will appear. If not licensed, your name will not appear. This means any event you acting as arbiter, all norms we will get not confirmed. This is norm will be canceled. You have to go for new norm. But from, I don't know, this FIDE Arbiters Commission, they changed some rules. I remember when I was 4 years ago, I was counselor of Arbiter Commission. It's not problem if you enter seminar before a tournament or enter tournament, you got your normal norm before seminar. It's okay for us, it was very, but the new FIDE arbiters member, I think they changed this regulation. They said that you have to enter first exam and pass the exam. Then you have to go after that. You can acting as the arbiter for event. So here, you know, the rules change. So this means if the this rules, they're using the any events you became arbiter and got your norm before exam, this is not considered. This will be canceled. You have to start after exam to collect the new norm because Arbiter Commission, they changed the rules. I remember 4 years ago, it was no problem. You can enter as an arbiter, no need to be first enter to exam. Now they changed the rules. I don't know why. They make a little bit tough. Became a little bit tough.
Okay, so it means that after exam, I have to complete my three norms and then log with the exam.
Yes, three norms from national events, from any rated event, even one of them can be rapid or be blitz, is okay, no problem. But for rapid or blitz must be minimum 30 players. For the standard chess, minimum 20 players for standard chess, minimum 20 players. And also you be sure the chief arbiter, and I am talking to everybody, all of you, once you got the norm from chief arbiter, be sure in the IT3, the tournament report, your name there. If your name not in the IT3, so the norm will not accept. Maybe a chief arbiter will give you norm, but in the IT3, it not mention your name, maybe mention others. So if your name not in the IT3, so even this norm will not consider.
Okay, I thought that I'm a licensed national arbiter, so my those events which I have participated as arbiter will be counted because I'm a licensed national arbiter. So my license, I will have to.
yeah. But that's, you know, this is always I'm saying that technical manager of the each national federation or arbiter commission for each national federation, they have to inform all arbiters, national arbiters, FIDE arbiter, international arbiter belong to the federation about any updating of FIDE commission because FIDE commission updating their regulation to get title. Now, as I hear, maybe by next year to get IA title, you have to enter to seminar and pass the exam in the seminar, then allowed you to get your FIDE international title. So they always they make something new rules. Make a little bit tough for the arbiter.
question which I answered to Mr. Mario Arias from Piro, regarding the norms, who report them to FIDE. So I said the tournament's norms will be sent by your national federation, and for the seminar norm, we will send to FIDE.
Yes, yes. For seminar, I am sending my report after the exam. I will send my report to the Arbitrage Commission with the mark, with the all marks for each one. Then they will publish only those who passed the exam. They publish the name and without mention any mark, because the previous 2 or 3 years ago, they published beside the name marks, and some it was score very bad. It was very shame and very bad for the arbiter. One of the got 30% or got 40%, very bad and shame. For that, they're not announcing for the mark, only announce who pass. They're not announce who not pass. So for that, nobody knows who not pass. Only for passing name will be there. But I wish all of you to pass the exam, I wish.
So okay, finally, the guy from Zambia appeared, Mr. Gerard Chibumba. Yes, can we give him just a last chance, please, Mr. Chibumba?
Okay, I just wanted to ask if an arbiter is progressing from national arbiter to FA,
okay,
in which category would they fall? Among those categories that you had listed, would they be in category D, or maybe there's a different category for that?
No, all new title direct go to category D. All new titles, FA or IA, when you go to title, you'll be under category D. To transfer from category D to C, you have to act as a chief arbiter or deputy chief arbiter in one title events, of continental or the zonal tournament, or any event, you be a chief arbiter or deputy chief, not normal arbiter, not match arbiter, deputy or chief arbiter. Then you, at least two or three, then you go to the C category. From C category to B category, the requirement, big thing, to have to be chief arbiter, deputy chief arbiter for continental championship or for world championship, something like this, big things. Then you transfer to other categories. So when you go up, need more and more, and it will be difficult to reach A category and B category. The need to be chief or deputy chief arbiter and continental championship. You know, continental championship. So always they look for the international arbiter or the strong arbiter, very knowledgeable. So they have a system. They have a system to go from D to C. D to C, no problem. Anybody can go. From C to B, little need to be hard job with the continental. And from B to A, this is tough. This is very difficult. Have to be chief or deputy in world championship and chess Olympiad and something big, big event.
Okay. The other thing was, you had mentioned if someone qualifies for the title of FA, they have to pay €50 as a license. But for category D, it was €80.
Yeah. It was €50. The Arbiters Commission, they increase. I don't know amount. They make some profit.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Okay, so I have two big subjects I didn't finish. I want to finish, otherwise you cannot answer in the exam. So I have rating calculation, pairing system, how you make pairing. Otherwise, the question will be cover the pairing and rating, you will not answer. So let me work. If you need, can I give you 10 minutes? Then after 10 minutes, we can continue. So I have only 1 hour. After 10 minutes, I have to cover two subjects.
Yes, please, Mr. Mahdi, we take only 10 minutes break, so thanks.
Okay, so when by 9 p.m. Cairo time, we start our session.